Hello students, today I am going to discuss with you a very interesting topic, stains and stain removing agent. Now, being a professional laundryman, he should know, definitely know, or he should having a clear knowledge about removal of various stains, how to remove it from the linens. Similarly, be a housekeeper, he should know how to remove the stains from the various objects. Now, Unit 5, Stains and Stain Removal, I have divided the topic into two sections. Section A, that is the definition of the stains, general process of removal of the stains and classification of stains, and Section B, that is the how to remove the various types of stains. So I am starting with the definition of the stains. A stain can be defined as a spot or located dislocation left on the fabrics on an object by the absorptions of the foreign material. So what do you mean by the stain? A spot or any mark which has been put on any object, it has been absorbed by any object or a linen by the foreign bodies. Now over here, general criteria of removal of the stains. Now I will explain you how to remove the various types of stains. First, identify the stains. Identify the stains means over there, we have to identify what type of stain it is, whether it is an animal stain, vegetable stain, mineral stain, etc. Classify the stain. Classify it. What type of stain it is. Select the reagent to be used. That means select the correct agents for the removal of the stains. Select the procedure to be used. How to remove the stains, select the correct procedure how to remove the particular stains, and process step by step for the removal of the stain. Practice step by step how to remove the stain. So this is a general process how you remove the stains. Now I'll show you the classification of the stains. This is you over here, that classification of the stains. Stains can be divided into 5 classifications over here. One is animal stains, comes from the blood, example blood. Vegetable stains, that is tomatoes. Next is grease stains, that comes from the oil paint. Next comes from the mineral stains, that is an example, I can say that is an ink stain. And acidic stain, that is a vinegar. Section B. Now I will discuss with you how to remove some common stains from an object or from a linen. Now first I say that is a ballpoint ink. I am having a pen in my hand. Sometimes from this pen our ink leaks and destroy our linens or our uniform. So how to remove this ink from our personal linens? So what we will do, rub lightly with a cotton ball soaked in a spirit. An old ballpoint ink may be soaked in a glycerin or it can be softened in a thread. So what I have to do is that rub lightly with a cotton ball. So I have to take a cotton ball. Next I have to soak in spirit and I have to rub lightly. And so this is a fresh ink stain I can just remove. And all ink stains can be removed by use of glycerin. Next comes the betel leaf. Now I don't have any betel leaf right now over here. So I can say how to remove the stains from the betel nail. Bleach with 1% of potassium permanganate. It's a name of a chemical. 1% of potassium permanganate. Then soak in 1% of oxalic acid dissolved in water. So bleach with 1% of potassium permanganate, then soak in 1% of oxalic acid dissolved in water, and slowly you will find the stain will becoming light and disappear. Next comes the blood stains. Soak in cold water about an hour. So blood stain, first you have to do one thing, you have to soak in cold water for 1 hour. Then transfer the into the lukewarm water containing and the detergent, and after that launder. So soak in water for 1 hour, then transfer to the lukewarm water which contains to the detergent, then wash it carefully, and then you will find that is a blood stain, it will disappear. Next comes the, over here, I am showing, this is a candle. The candle wax stain, sometimes wax falls in our, in any linens or you can say any dress material. So how, and it makes a marks on that. So how will you remove this candle wax stains? Now scrape off the surface with a blunt knife. So take a blunt knife and slowly scrape off the surface. Place next over there, place the stain with 2 sheets of tissue paper on a or blotting paper and place it with a warm iron. After that, on the top of the, on the surface of the stain, place a tissue paper or blotting paper and place a warm iron on it. So what will happen? The wax will melt and the stains of that will disappear. Next comes the chewing gum. How will you remove the stains of the chewing gum? Now remove the surface of the gum with a blunt knife. Again you will remove the surface with a blunt knife. Apply the ice on the stains. Allow to soak it in a cold water and launder. So first step, just blunt it, just scrap it with a blunt knife. Next, you just do apply some cold ice with water, cold ice on that, and ultimately you launder it. Next, how will you remove the stains from the chocolate? I am showing you a chocolate over here. How are you going to remove the stains of the chocolate? Now, chocolate stains can be removed same as blood. So you know that is the few minutes back I have explained you how to remove the blood stain. Similarly, the same process you can remove, that is a how to remove, that is a chocolate stains. Next comes how to remove the stains from tea and coffee. So I am having over here in my hand a tea bag over here, a tea packet. So how will you remove the stains of tea and coffee? Pour boiling water over the stain, apply the borax solution and allow them to dry. So first pour boiling water on the stain, apply the borax solution and allow them to dry. Pour the boiling water over it and then launder. So first what you have to do for removal of tea stains, pour boiling water. So put boiling water over the stains, then apply the borax solution. Apply some borax solution on it and allow them to dry. Let them allow them for the dry. Then pour some warm water and launder. Next comes the curry stains. Curry stains over here, that is over here, how to remove? So you remove the curry stain, apply the detergent. First wash it with a detergent properly, give to the sunlight, back to the sunlight, check whether the curry stains or the gravy stains is removed or not. If it is not removed, again wash it with the detergent, and then this process you remove the gravy stains or curry stain.
Now, how to remove the stains from the egg? That means egg yolk, that yellow portions of the egg, how will you going to remove it? So, soak in detergent water and warm salt solution water. So, you take a water containing detergent and one pinch or two pinch of salt. And after that, what you will do, the water should be warm. Then launder it. By this way, you can remove that is a egg yolk or egg, that is a egg yolk stains over there. Next comes, how to remove the fruit stains. I am having in my hand a mango. So sometimes the juices of the fruits may fall on our faces or the linens, and it's very difficult to remove it. So how to remove the fruit stains over here? You have to soak in warm water solution and launder. So again, soak in warm water, having the detergent and launder. Next comes, how to remove the stains from the ghee and oil. Yeah, so sometimes those who are working in a kitchen, so their uniforms and dresses sometimes become dirty with the ghee stains and oil stains. How will you going to remove this? So rub it with a French chop or a stain that would be bunch up. So what you will do? Rub it with a French chop, which is a type of a chop, and launder it. So this time here, this ghee stains will be removed. Henna stains, you are very aware about the term henna. Girls used to wear in their hands. So how to remove the henna stains? Soak in warm milk for half an hour and launder. So over here, henna stain, make sure that don't soak in water. Soak in warm milk and then launder. Next comes over there, lipstick stains. I'm having a lipstick in my hand. Just check it. So how to remove the lipstick stains over here? So lipstick stain, soften the stain by rubbing the glycerin into it. So you take a glycerin, a portion of glycerin, rub it on the stain, and then launder it. So this way you can slowly just remove the lipstick stains. How will you clean the shoe polish stain? Now the shoe polish stains can be cleaned by using by the detergent. So just put the linen which is get dirty by the shoe polish or shoe, that is a polish stain, in a detergent, warm water. Just wash it carefully, and now this way the stains will be disappeared. Now I've come across, there is another term called a spotter. Now who are called as spotters? The persons who are working in a laundry who are experienced in removal of spots and stains from the linens. They are called as spotters. So I'm repeating once more. They are working in the laundry, so they having a knowledge and experience of removing of various types of stains, so they are called as spotters. So in this chapter you have learned about that is what do you mean by stains, that how many types of stains and how to remove the various types of stains. Thank you.